research scholar from Department of Islamic Studies, Aligarh Muslim University. Today the topic of my presentation is towards the role of Indo-Islamic art and architecture in fostering the culture of peace and justice in India. So due to lack of time, I will just summarize my whole paper into few points. So my first point is that in order to contribute in creating peace, Islamic art and architecture has been crucial, because the social values and religious beliefs together have been unveiled by architecture, because it provides a lot of symbols, meanings and imagery. The lofty religious structures in India, they have not been built for religious purpose or worship, but they also became the center of social activities. For instance, we can take the example, the entrance of Jama Masjid. It gives a sense of modesty. So we can say that the vastness and openness of mosque, it signifies the congregational values of worship. Secondly, the mihrab. The mihrab, it is considered as the direction of heaven. The openness of mosque is both an antidote to the false plenitude and materiality of the world, as well as it gives an inner sense of void and purity. Secondly, the arcs. The arcs, they are not meaningless, because they symbolize two principles, that is of the heaven and earth. The domes, they are static, yet they rest like a crown of peace and beauty. So high art in India, they are considered as the symbol of peace and harmony. Secondly, my second point is the impact of, Sufism on art and architecture. The Sufi shrines and martyrs tombs, they are considered as the places of spiritual, healing and harmonious coexistence, particularly in Indian society. The shrines of Muinuddin Chishti, Salar Masood Ghazi, Nizamuddin Auliya, they all are symbols of peaceful coexistence in a pluralistic society, because they all give special attention to interaction with different traditions. Secondly, they are the places of power, both spiritual and secular, because even the rulers, they have given special attention to these places and they have considered them as sacred. So more importantly, the architecture of these Sufi shrines, they are marvelous examples of Indo-Islamic art and architecture. If you see the Nizamuddin Auliya Dargah, it is encamped with a lotus cap, which is very beautiful. Secondly, the Nizami Gate at Ajmer, it has embellishments of gold and ivory colors, which is its beauty is very, serene. Secondly, the detailing, it purely reflects the Indo-Islamic art. If we can take the example of Dhai Dinkaj Gopra, just beside the tomb of Ajmer, it shows the significance of that place as the architectural, not as just as the architectural monument of historic importance, but also as the meeting place of culture. So they are more empowering peace, love, serenity, justice, godliness, and everything that is spiritual. Thank you.